Hello and welcome. You are finally here. My name is Maxim Cruz, and today we are analyzing purchasing multifamily properties using FHA loans. So this is part of a video series. If you haven't watched some of the introduction videos, make sure you go and watch them. Go and check out why I say in certain scenarios it's better to buy versus to rent, especially if you're buying multifamily units, 2, 3, or 4 unit properties where you can get an FHA loan with 3.5% down. Also, make sure to check out the other video that talks about some of the basic terminology. Now, this video is actually a special video. The first probably 10 videos are a special video for my friend Denzel Rodriguez, the finance geek, who introduced me to Velocity Banking, and I really appreciate it because this works in these units, and trust me, when you have more units and when you invest in bigger deals, this also works as well. So Denzel, this is a special video for you and all of the Kingdom citizens. Welcome, and let's go ahead and learn how you can start investing in multifamily properties using FHA loans with 3.5% down payment. Now, I am a licensed real estate broker, so my typical disclosure, this is for information purposes only. This is not investment advice. Whatever investment advice you're seeking, I encourage you to communicate with your local investment professional. So this is for information purposes only. And again, I'm here to help you learn how you can start investing with FHA loans, you know, and investing in real estate. So let's get right into it. This is actually an existing property that I found on the MLS. Being a real estate broker, I do have access to the MLS as well as off-market deals. So we could analyze both scenarios. For this one, I'm actually disclosing everything because there's nothing to hide here. The address, today's date is January 2nd, 2019. The address for this property is 404 Northeast 4th Street in Pompano Beach. MLS number F like Frank 10203381. Currently, this property was listed on November 19, 2019. The list price is $375,000. This broker is actually very unique. You don't get this from a lot of the brokers, but there's actually a cool breakdown on, you know, the monthly rents and all that stuff. So this was very useful. But nevertheless, I still took a look at the tax record and took a look at some of the expenses that are shown here. And let's go through these numbers one by one here. All right. So the list price is $375,000, okay? The number of units on this property is 2 units, so that qualifies for FHA financing. Remember, for you to qualify for FHA financing, 2 up to 4 units, you can buy a 4-unit building using FHA financing. Okay, so unit 1 is 3 bedrooms, 1 bathroom. Unit 2 is 3 bedrooms, 1 bathroom. In the property here, it says duplex in the heart of Pompano Beach, turnkey operation. Roof is only about 4 to 5 years old. Both units have central AC, hurricane shutter, separate water meter, separate electric washer and dryer. Rents are below market. So then he discloses all this stuff. Based on the pictures, the property looks fairly decent on the outside and on the inside. You know, pretty simple, nothing fancy, pretty basic. So, you know, let's see what we have here. So right now, based on the numbers, these units are actually rented out at $1,200 every single month, okay? The market rent, based on what this realtor is putting on here, is $1,600. In my honest opinion, I would probably go for the $1,450 range just because it is kind of a basic unit. It doesn't have granite finishes, or there isn't a pool, or there isn't a lot of amenities. So, you know, when you're competing, when you really gotta, when a tenant moves out and you have it on the market, for you to say you're gonna get $1,600 when the area on average is between $1,600 to $1,700 for a 3-bedroom, but these are units with amenities and apartment complexes, gated communities, et cetera, you know, I would be more conservative and probably shoot for the $1,450 range, okay? So now let's go here. I know you're anxious to look at these numbers, but let's go here And let's look at three scenarios. Now, again, for the financing scenario, we have a 30-year FHA mortgage, which right now with today's interest rates is roughly 4%. Financing, again, we're doing 3.5% down. That means that out of pocket for the purchase price of $375,000, you're doing a down payment of $13,125. Based on this information, if you go to mortgagecalculator.com, or you could just search any mortgage calculators, there's also be a link in the description, your principal, interest, and PMI. Remember, PMI is that private mortgage insurance, because you're only putting 3.5% down. Your monthly payment will be $1,879 for that. But let's not finish there. Again, as owner occupied, let's focus thing here. So right now the market rent is $1,200. So let's say worst case scenario, you bought this property and the most you're able to collect is $1,200. That means on an annual basis, your gross income would be $14,400. Now, after you calculate your taxes, which are not gonna change, $4,366, your landscaping, so you're gonna have to do some landscaping. Your insurance is $3,000. So here on the landscaping, there's zero, because as the owner, I would figure you could do your own landscaping. And also here, the only other expense that's not added in there is any sort of maintenance. So it would be good to have some sort of a dollar figure. Maybe it's $100 a month, so $1,200 for the year for some basic maintenance that might come up. But nevertheless, I did not include it in this analysis, just so you could see what's going on. Financing. So because you're doing finances, the $1,879 per month for the 12 months, the total financing that you're going to pay for the year is $22,584. Since your rental income is $14,400, once you subtract the expenses, once you subtract financing, you are actually out of pocket $15,550, which means for the owner that is going to occupy this property, they will be paying $1,291.67 every single month. Where the market rent is $1,200, again, going back to my first video, that's where you have to weigh out the options. Hey, if you're gonna live in this area, if your kids go to school here, if you love the job that you're at, or you have a business that's running there, maybe this works for you, because hey, you're only paying about $100 more out of pocket, maybe $200 if their certain maintenance item comes in versus the rent, and you're building up some equity, you have some property, you have some cash flow from your tenants, etc., etc. And then again, if you're able to raise the rents, you know, then you could really start to do something. Okay, now let's look at it from a pure investment. And this is, again, for those that are more seasoned. Again, if you're already more seasoned, a two unit, you know, is probably not gonna work out for you. You have to look at more units. Obviously, FHA financing is not gonna work out for you. You have to look at conventional financing. But so you get into the rhythm of analyzing property, let's look at this from an investment cap on. Let's put our investor's cap on and let's go ahead and analyze this if we were investors. All right, so at the current market rate of $2,400, which is unit one and unit two, both of them are rented, we're investors, we're not living there, that would give you on an annual basis $28,800. After you pay your taxes, this case you have landscaping, this case you have insurance. Again, there isn't anything in there for maintenance or a property manager, etc. So these expenses, I would say, are a little bit low. Your financing is zero. You're buying this property cash, $375,000 cash. Your NOI would be $20,594. If we analyze cap rate, remember, cap rate is just the relationship between your net operating income and the purchase price, or in some scenarios, investors look at it as the money that they actually put into the property. You would actually be 5.49%. So again, this is not investment advice, but in theory, you're making 5.49% on your $375,000 investment. So that's the money you're making. Now, let's look at it still as investors, but now let's leverage using financing. So what does that mean? That means that for this property, the number stayed the same, $375,000. I'm gonna go to the bank and I'm gonna get a loan 20% down, okay? $70,000 I'm gonna put in of my own money. That means that there is no PMI. Because I'm not using FHA, there is no PMI, there is no private mortgage insurance. So my principal and interest payment based on that would be $1,433. Next, let's subtract the taxes, the landscaping, the insurance, all those numbers stay the same. Our financing number, $1,433 over 12 months would equal $17,196. What does that mean? That means that after we pay the financing, after we pay all the expenses, all that stuff, we have $3,398 left over. Now, again, because some investors, only like 1% of the investors that I've worked with have looked at it this way, but again, it's just a different way of thinking about money. They're putting in $70,000 to get $3,398 back every single year, which would give them a cap rate of 4.8%. Some investors say, hey, my return on this is 4.8%. Again, not that great overall when you're looking at investments. You know, this property as a pure investment at this scenario probably doesn't work. But now, let's take a look at this, and this is where real estate is exciting. So this realtor, the listing agent for this property, said that the market rent is $1,600. In my personal opinion, I think $1,450 is more realistic. So now let's analyze these numbers. If I use the $1,450 number at the same $375,000 purchase price, if I'm buying a cash investment, all of a sudden my NOI goes up about $6,000, which gives me a cap rate of 7.09%. What does that mean? That means that I'm putting in $375,000 to get back $26,594 at 7.09% return, if that's what you want to call it. Leveraged. Now this becomes very interesting for those that maybe can't get into those bigger deals and are looking for some things. Let's look at the leverage numbers. Again, in this scenario, I'm saying the market rent is $1,450. My NOI at that point is $9,398, which now all of a sudden is 13.43%. Because remember, I'm in putting in $70,000 and I'm getting back $9,398. Now this number starts to look very, very attractive, right? And for our owner occupieds, our NOI is still a negative, you know, so there's still an out-of-pocket expense at $12,550. So again, our monthly out-of-pocket expense is $1,045.83. So now what did we see here? We saw that this number, just by getting a little bit more in market rent, you know, all of a sudden, instead of paying the monthly $1,291, now it's only $1,045. Now, if this individual that's buying this using this scenario, using this $1,450 number, if the unit that they're at, if they're currently paying, let's say $1,300 a month, and now all of a sudden they're paying $1,045, guess what? We just created cash flow. For all of our Kingdom citizens, you know how important cash flow is. That's another, you know, if it's $1,300 and now it's $1,045, that's $250 in cash flow every single month that you're able to use to leverage velocity banking. So this is beautiful. Now, my truly favorite part about real estate is that everything is negotiable, right? This property, again, was listed on November 19, 2019. Let's say you're in the market for the property, you've gone to the bank, you've gotten some pre-qualification, maybe you're working on your credit, so maybe you're 3 to 6 months away from actually buying the property. And this market, now all of a sudden we're in June of 2020, and hey, this market has been on the market, this property has been on the market for 7-8 months. There's not much activity going on, which is telling what? Probably the owner has to reduce the price to make this realistic. So all of a sudden now we get an owner occupied The owner is desperate because Florida is too hot for them. They want to go back to, I don't know, the northern states or Canada or leave the country or whatever. So all of a sudden, the owner says, hey, look, just sell the property. I want to get it sold no matter what. And the owner puts in an offer for $325,000. It gets accepted. The deal goes through and this owner buys this real estate asset at $325,000, $50,000 less than what it was listed for. Now, for my friends, all of you that are outside of Florida that might be going, hey, this is never going to happen, let me tell you, I grew up north of Boston in Massachusetts as well, in a city called Methuen, and then eventually moved to Haverhill, Massachusetts. And trust me, in the Northeast, it was different, right? When the property value was listed for $375,000, it was probably plus or minus $10,000. There was a little bit room there, but that was the price. Here in Miami, based on my experience of what I've seen so far, I don't know why, I don't know what the mentality is, but it is very typical for you to see for somebody to list a property very, very high and then to actually sell it at some cases even $100,000 less than what it was listed for. So trust me when I say this, this is not a crazy idea. You can make an offer. The worst thing that can happen is that they'll say no. You're gonna drive your real estate agent a little bit crazy, but if you have a pre-approval in hand and you're ready to go with down payment money and you know you're already pre-qualified and you're serious about doing this, trust me, your real estate agent will see that you're working with them and you're just looking to get the best deal. And especially if you're watching these videos, you can say, hey, look, this doesn't make sense to me. You know, I can't buy it at that price because the numbers just don't work. You know, $1,291 is what I'm paying out of pocket. I'm paying kind of the same thing for rent, so that doesn't work. But let's see if this number works. So let's take a look at this scenario. $325,000 now, right? So because you have your principal, your insurance, and your PMI, your private mortgage insurance, that monthly payment is $1,627.97. Now all of a sudden, your annual payment is $19,535.64. So in this scenario where we had, you know, the principal insurance and PMI was $1,879, so that was $22,584. In this scenario, it's almost $3,000 less, right? So now again, once we subtract all of these expenses, the taxes, the insurance, and the financing, we are still negative. The owner on this property is still negative. That means they have to put money out of pocket. But how much money out of pocket? Now all of a sudden, their money out of pocket is $791.80. So guess what? If they're paying $1,200, $1,300, and now, you know, they got the deal, they negotiated with the buyer, with the seller, they got them to go down to $325. Now all of a sudden they're paying $791.80 cash flow, baby, right? So now instead of paying $1,300 a month out of pocket for rent, now as owner investor, now all of a sudden it's $791. That's, you know, $500. If it's $1,300 minus that, $508.20 coming to you as extra cash flow that you can utilize velocity banking and make this work for you. So let me know what you think about this video. Let me know what you think about this property. Again, I disclosed all the information. You could go ahead and look it up. If you're watching this at a further date and this property is no longer in the market, well, hopefully, you know, you bought it with, a real estate agent that I referred to you, or you bought this deal on your own and you got a good deal and you were able to negotiate and you were able to maneuver these numbers. So now you can analyze this as a pro and say, hey, what works for me? And this is how I got started, right? If you watch my first video, I shared how I bought a 4-unit and, you know, the first month we were living there for free. And, I do have another unit that I actually analyzed. It's a 4-unit, also located in Pompano Beach. And for the owner user, they live for free at that property. So stay tuned for that video. Again, this is the power of real estate. I'm not even talking about the other contributing factors, which are, you know, appreciation. If you're gonna sell this property in 5 years or 7 years and you have some capital gains, so let's say you bought it for $325, now the property is worth $400,000 because the market has changed or whatever. You know, so you have $75,000 in capital gains, which is the difference between your final sale price and your purchase price. You know, now you have $75,000. Guess what? As owner occupant, you might not have to pay taxes on it. And even as an investor, if you do a 1031 exchange where you're taking the money out and putting it towards another real estate investment, all you're doing is deferring your taxes. 1031 exchange stands for deferred tax exchange. So that's what you're doing. That's the power of real estate. You can hold this property forever. You know, your tenants will pay it off 30 years from now if you're paying $800 a month. Whatever, 2 years from now, you decide to move out, you decide to rent your unit for $1,450. Now, all of a sudden, instead of you paying $791 out of pocket, now all of a sudden you have $1,450 coming in rent. So that's an extra cash flow that you're creating. So you had cash flow while you were there, if you understand what I'm talking about, which is the difference from your rental, what you were already paying as a renter. Now, because you live there as an owner, you're only paying $791. You have that extra almost, $510 of cash flow. Now, all of a sudden, you move out of the property. You don't want to get rid of it. Tenants are going well. You know how to manage them well. You know, cutting the grass isn't a big deal or whatever. Now, all of a sudden, you rent it out for $1,450. Guess what? You have that extra cash flow come in. Now maybe you hire a landscaper so you don't have to go buy. You're managing these units still, so there's still a little bit of work that's involved, but every single month, you know, you have another, you know, $600 coming into your pocket because you decide to do that investment. And not only that, but think of it this way, and this is where I think the biggest mind hack is. If, you know, right here in this scenario where the $325,000, if you had to put 3.5% down on that, it's roughly, I think it's like $10,000 on that. If you're already cash flow positive, because now you're, instead of paying $1,300 in rent, you're paying $791, you're paying $800, that's $500. If you put $10,000 down, that means in 20 months, the money that you invested, you theoretically and practically got it back, right? Because you have that extra cash flow every single month. And I mean, that's just amazing. What other investment can you do where you can put up some money like that, have a true asset or whatever? And I know I'm gonna get comments and haters of people saying, well, if you invested in whatever, you're gonna get 15% and 30% or 300% if you're in cryptocurrency. I'm not gonna get into that. But anyways, that is the power of real estate. That's why I'm so passionate about it. How is your life gonna be completely transformed, completely changed when instead of paying, you know, $1,450 in rent, you're paying $791? You have money coming in, you have cash flow, you're building equity, you're building wealth. Now you can go ahead and apply velocity banking to your practical scenario. You can get home equity line of credit. You can sell the property. You can buy another property. You can keep on flipping your money, making your money work for you. Real estate is awesome. I love real estate, and this is why I do it. I have the pleasure now of working on some bigger deals and you know, working with different sizes of investors and looking at completely different portfolios and scenarios. But nevertheless, this is how I got started somewhat. And look, this is today's date. This is the property. You can do this in today's market. You can do this. Just don't pay $375. Pay $325 and the numbers will work, right? Make the offer. Don't be afraid to make offers. If you sit down with a real estate professional and you have your pre-qualification, your pre-approval from your bank, which is step number one, make sure you get pre-approved. And you say, hey, I'm looking at all this stuff at $375. For me, it does not work, but let's make an offer at $325 because this is what I want to put in for the property. And maybe you're somewhere in the middle, you know, in the 340 range, you're still probably under $1,000. So if you're paying $1,300 a month, you're still cash flowing $300 positive. Come on, people, get excited about this stuff. You know, I love real estate. This is my passion. Hopefully you were able to enjoy this video. You were able to learn something from it. I'm going to continue bringing you more videos, more scenarios of actual real property and really getting down the really gritty numbers and counting pennies and dollars so you can see and you can start to do this on your own. I'm going to go ahead and create this sheet right here. So it'll actually be in an Excel spreadsheet format. So you can go in and you can put in all of these values and then it'll automatically just feed all of those numbers on there. And then you'll be able to manipulate them how they want. There will be a disclosure. Use that for your information purposes. It's not an investment analysis tool at all. If you want to learn syndication, if you want to learn investment analysis, I can refer you to some other people. Make sure to comment below and I'll comment back, or go ahead and reach out to me directly and I'd be more than happy to refer those resources to you. So with all that being said, get excited about real estate, start investing in your own property. You know, don't pay more per month for rent when you're able to buy, especially if you can buy an FHA mortgage with, you know, $13,000, that really isn't a lot of money. You know, there's a lot of people out there that are paying $6,000 to $8,000 just to move into an apartment. So when for a couple thousand dollars more, you can do that. I mean, this is just endless. So with all that being said, have an awesome day. Hopefully you enjoyed this video and I'll see you on the next one.